What's up, everyone? It's your boy NorenRad89 here, bringing another rad movie review. Today we're going to be talking about Luca, Pixar's new animated film. It's kind of like a fish out of water storyline, so let's get down to talking about. This is going to be a non-spoiler review. Roll it. So Luca is Pixar's new animated film. It's like it has an Italian-based cast and everything, and it's basically about a sea monster who is able to go on land and first, like, you know, fish out of water storyline, investigates land for the first time. When the sea monsters come out of the land, they turn into humans, like, after they're not wet anymore, and he's able to explore this new Italian town and experience life kind of for the first time out of water. So let's get down to talking about the positives of this film. So the first big positive that I could think of with Luca is the animation style is very beautiful. Like, in terms of Pixar, I know their stuff is always really top-notch and very crisp looking, but this one, just because of the sea setting and the coloration, and then it has like this very colorful Italian like town on the border of like the water, like, oh man, like, it's very beautiful, and I really did appreciate all that key crisp animation in this film. And then our key, like, main characters, Luca, Alberto. Luca is the key, like, sea monster that's, like, the first time experiencing, like, land for the first time. Alberto's the one that kind of drags him out there and makes him take that first step and starts showing him land. Has, like, all these weird knowledge things that he drops on Luca because Alberto thinks that he knows everything. He thinks that he knows everything about land, so he's got really all these weird, like, things. Like, he thinks the stars are fish. He calls the stars in the sky fish. Like, it's really funny, interesting stuff like that. Then they meet a female character, the little girl who's the daughter of a sea monster hunter, and like, it's really funny just their, like, play, like, the three of them together on screen. Like, they had such a good chemistry, those characters, and the way they reacted to scenes, and they're going into that race to enter to win the Vespa. Like, it just has some really funny moments between those three characters, and I really did appreciate that. Also, it's a really good wholesome storyline for the family. You know, it's not like too dark or anything, or have like moments that you're gonna feel terrified. Like, I really didn't feel threatened or dark like during this film. You know, some films have that dark side when it comes to like animated films, you know, losing a family member or something happening, like the fights. Like, this film is actually quite a wholesome, good storyline about, like, you know, becoming, you know, of age, you know, and meeting new friends and experimenting and exploring things for the first time. So it's a really good wholesome just story that you can really watch with your kids and enjoy it. So let's get down to talking about some of the negatives for this film. And one of the key negatives right off the bat is that our villain character, our main, like, he's not even really a villain character. He's mainly more like a bully. Him and his two little henchmen, like, they're probably one of the weakest, like, villain type, you know, antagonist characters that we have in a Pixar film. Like, they're very unforgettable. You're not going to remember those characters at all. Also, there's, like, some weird parts, like, in the story where it just doesn't do enough world building. Like, it's mainly focused on our three main characters, you know, but like, in terms of the world around it, there's not a lot of world building, like, you know, Incredibles or Monsters, Inc., like some of the other Pixar films. So that kind of, this one has a little notch down on it because of that reason. And then also there's just some funny moments in the movie. Like, they're funny and they're key moments, but like, there's nothing in the movie, like, I could feel like what I want to say is like stakes. Like, there's no high stakes moments. Like, even when the kids are like, they can be discovered when they get wet outside of the water, you know, and like, you know, that town doesn't really like sea monsters. They're sea monster hunters and they're, you know, fishermen and all that kind of stuff, this town, so they really don't like them at all. So, but I still didn't feel threatened or at like scared for our characters at all. Like I said, it's a very wholesome, good storyline, very easy to get attached to, but it's not something that's going to pull you in emotionally and, like, you know, get tears out of you or like get that emotional connection. Like, it didn't for me. But overall, in my book, I had a good time watching Luca with the kids. Like, they all loved it and everything. In my book, this film is going to get a 7.5 out of 10. It's still a very good, solid watch. There's just some other good Pixar films out there because they have, like, very iconic villains or more in-depth emotional connective storylines. But this one is definitely a beautiful film to look at. It's got a cool, simple, wholesome storyline that you'll like. And I like our three main characters and the way they interact on screen. It was really good to see them together. And if you haven't yet, drop a like and hit that subscribe button. It definitely helps out the channel so you can stay up to date on all the content that I put out and everything. I got other movie reviews and other rankings that I do and all that kind of stuff. I'm actually following through with Rick and Morty season 5, so when episode 2 drops, I'll have my review for that episode. And I already reviewed episode 1. I'll probably have a card in the top corner so you can click on that after this video. Thanks for sticking around with me, guys. Have a safe and happy day, everyone. Peace out.